Let's pray. Father in heaven, we thank you for this morning. We thank you for keeping us safe last night and for giving us good rest last night. We thank you for another glorious Sabbath morning. And we thank you, Father, for this opportunity to meet in this manner, Lord, to worship you as a body of believers. And we ask that you will give us the grace, the strength, the discipline of mind to worship you in spirit and in truth. For truly, God, you are worthy to receive all praise, all honor, all worship, all power. And we pray that as mortal people, weak and sinful as we are, God, that you'll help us to worship you, that our whole being may be lifted up to remember who you are, to remember this glorious person that you are, and to worship you, Lord. Forgive us, Lord, of our many sins, O God. Forgive us, God, for the things that we have done, the things that we have said. Lord, forgive us for all these things, O God, and cleanse us, O Lord, with the blood of Christ. We pray to you, God. Cleanse us with the blood of Christ, that we may be white as snow. And clothe us with the righteousness of Jesus Christ, that we may come to your throne of grace, that we may come to your throne of mercy, O Lord, and offer you this worship, Lord. Father God, bless this service. Bless the reading of your word. Bless the songs. Bless the liturgy. Bless especially, Father, the message that will be brought by your servant, O Lord. Bless it, Father God. Bless it, Father God, that it may enrich each one of us, O God, that it may edify our souls, O God, that it may build us up, O Lord, that it may draw us closer to you, O God. Bless it, Father. And we ask, Father, that at this time, Lord, you will fill our souls, you will fill our hearts, O Lord, with your love. You will fill us, O God, with the fear of God, that we may be careful in whatever we do. And we ask, Father, that even at this time, you may fill our homes with your glorious presence, O God. That, Lord, at the end of this worship, we may know that you have met with us, and that, O God, we have met with you, and our hearts may be lifted, that we may go off rejoicing because we have met with you, O Lord. Father, have pity on us. Have mercy, O God, and bless us, O God. Lord, we give you thanks for all that you are, Lord. We give you praise, O Lord. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Amen.
Call to worship. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Come thou fount of every blessing, tune my heart to sing thy grace. Streams of mercy never ceasing, call for songs of loudest praise. Teach me some melodious sonnet sung by flaming tongues above. Praise the mount, I'm fixed upon it, mount of thy redeeming love. My Ebenezer, here by thy great help I've come, and I hope by thy good pleasure safely to arrive at home. Jesus sought me when a stranger, wandering from the fold of God, he to rescue from danger interposed his precious blood. from sinning, I shall see thy lovely face. Clothed then in blood-washed linen, how I'll sing thy sovereign grace. Come, my Lord, no longer tarry, take my ransomed soul away. Send thine angels now to carry me to realms of endless day. Oh, to grace, how great a debtor daily I am constrained to be. Let thy goodness, like a fetter, bind my wandering heart to thee. Prone to wander, Lord, I feel it. Prone to leave the God I love. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above. Here's my heart, oh, take and seal it. Seal it for thy courts above.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, to the end of ages. Amen.
Holy, 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 Lord God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest.
Blessed is he that has come and is to come again in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, almighty Lord.
Holy art thou, immortal Lord.
O Lord, the Messiah, who was crucified for us, have mercy on us.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, almighty Lord.
Holy art thou, immortal Lord.
O Lord, the Messiah, who was crucified for us, have mercy on us.
Holy art thou, O God.
Holy art thou, almighty Lord.
Holy art thou, immortal Lord.
O Lord, the Messiah, who was crucified for us, have mercy on us.
O Lord, have mercy on us.
O Lord, have mercy on us and bless us.
O Lord, accept our praise and worship and have mercy on us.
Glory be to you, O God.
Glory be to you, O Creator.
O Christ, the King, who has compassion on your sinful servants, have mercy on us. Glory be to you. Bless us, O Lord.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
O Lord God, enlighten us with the rays of your blissful and shining light. Cheer this day with the joy of your resurrection from the dead. Make us joyful by your lordship. God, our Messiah, who is the hope of our life and Savior of our souls, strengthen us with the power of your grace.
Amen.
Have mercy on me, O God, according to your steadfast love, according to your abundant mercy, blot out my many transgressions.
Wash me thoroughly from my iniquity, and cleanse me from my sin.
For I know my transgressions and my sin is ever before me.
Against you, you only have I sinned and done that which is evil in your sight.
Purge me with hyssop and I shall be clean. Wash me and I shall be whiter than snow.
Hide your face from my sins and blot out all my iniquities.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and put a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take not your Holy Spirit from me.
Restore to me the joy of your salvation, and uphold me with a willing spirit.
O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth will show forth your praise.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and forever shall be. Amen. O God,
our loving and merciful Father, we now confess our many and innumerable sins. Our sins have degraded us. We have caused grief and loss to others. We have caused dishonor and loss to your glory and sorrow to your paternal love. We confess our sins of the mind and body and our shortcomings in private and public life. Heavenly Father, forgive us all these sins. O loving Jesus, take away our burden of sin. O sanctifying Spirit, sanctify us. O triune God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit,
confirm us in the heritage
of your children, and hear our prayers in the name of the Lord.
Amen.
May the Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who by His great mercy has promised us forgiveness of sins to all of them who with hearty repentance and true faith turn to Him, have mercy on you, pardon and deliver you from all your sins, strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Praise God in His sanctuary. Praise Him in His mighty firmament.
Praise Him for His mighty deeds. Praise Him according to His exceeding greatness.
Praise Him with trumpet sound. Praise Him with the flute and harp.
Praise Him with timbre and dance. Praise Him with strings and pipes.
Praise Him with sounding cymbals. Praise Him with loud clashing cymbals.
Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord.
Glory be to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever, shall be, world without end. Amen.
Praise of the angels. Weak and sinful as we are, we bring praises to you like the angels above.
May there be praises in heaven, peace on earth, and unity among us. Almighty Father, Heavenly King, and Creator of all, we worship you and adore you, and bring you praise because you are worthy of all praises. O Messiah, the one among the Trinity with the Father and the Holy Spirit, who came to take away the sins of the world, have mercy upon us. O Saviour of the world, lend your ear to our humble supplications. O the one who is seated at the right of the Heavenly Father, you alone are the Holy One. We pray that you be merciful to us and bless us. We ascribe praise to you, our Lord, the Messiah, together with the Holy Spirit, for you have glorified the Father. Amen.
O Lord, the Messiah, we pray that you shut not the door of your blessings against us.
O Lord, we confess that we are sinners. Bless us.
O Lord, your love brought you down among us so that our death would be averted by your death.
O Lord, shower your blessings upon us. Amen.
It plants me like a tree that's rooted by the streams of life. So Lord, set your word in me. Your word, oh Lord, enlightens my way, and by this light I see. It guides me. Speak.
The first lesson for today is taken from Genesis chapter 1, verse 1 to verse 28. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. Now the earth was formless and empty. Darkness was over the surface of the deep, and the Spirit of God was hovering over the waters. And God said, "Let there be light," and there was light. God saw that the light was good, and he separated the light from the darkness. God called the light day, and the darkness he called night. And there was evening, and there was morning, the first day. And God said, "Let there be an expanse between the waters to separate water from water." So God made the expanse and separated the water under the expanse from the water above it, and it was so. God called the expanse sky. And there was evening and there was morning, the second day. And God said, "Let the water under the sky be gathered to one place, and let dry ground appear." And it was so. God called the dry ground land, and the gathered waters he called seas. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, "Let the land produce vegetation, seed-bearing plants and trees on the land that bear fruit with seed in it, according to their various kinds." And it was so. The land produced vegetation, plants bearing seed according to their kinds, and trees bearing fruit with seed in it according to their kinds. And God saw that it was good. And there was evening, and there was morning, the third day. And God said, "Let there be lights in the expanse of the sky to separate the day from the night, and let them serve as signs to mark seasons and days and years, and let them be lights in the expanse of the sky to give light on the earth." And it was so. God made two great lights, the greater light to govern the day and the lesser light to govern the night. He also made the stars. God set them in the expanse of the sky to give light on the earth, to govern the day and the night, and to separate light from darkness. And God saw that it was good, and there was evening, and there was morning, the fourth day. And God said, "Let the water teem with living creatures, and let birds fly above the earth across the expanse of the sky." So God created the great creatures of the sea and every living and moving thing with which the water teems, according to their kinds, and every winged bird according to its kind. And God saw that it was good. God blessed them and said, "Be fruitful and increase in number, and fill the water in the seas, and let the birds increase on the earth. And there was evening, and there was morning, the fifth day. And God said, let the land produce living creatures according to their kinds, livestock, creatures that move along the ground, and wild animals, each according to its kind. And it was so. God made the wild animals according to their kinds, the livestock according to their kinds, and all the creatures that move along the ground according to their kinds. And God saw that it was good. Then God said, let us make man in our image, in our likeness, and let them rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, over the livestock, over all the earth, and over all the creatures that move along the ground. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God he created him. Male and female he created them. God blessed them and said to them, be fruitful and increase in number. Fill the earth and subdue it. Rule over the fish of the sea and the birds of the air, and over every living creature that moves on the ground. Here ends the first lesson.
Today's second reading is taken from Ephesians chapter 2, verse 11 to 22. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 11 to 22. Jew and Gentile reconciled through Christ. Therefore, remember that formerly you who are Gentiles by birth and called uncircumcised by those who call themselves the circumcision, which is done in the body by human hands. Remember that at that time you were separate from Christ, excluded from citizenship in Israel, and foreigners to the covenants of the promise, without hope and without God in the world. But now, in Christ Jesus, you who once were far away have been brought near by the blood of Christ. For he himself is our peace, who has made the two groups one and has destroyed the barrier, the dividing wall of hostility, by setting aside in his flesh the law with its commands and regulations. His purpose was to create in himself one new humanity out of the two, thus making peace, and in one body to reconcile both of them to God through the cross, by which he put to death their hostility. He came and preached peace to you who were far away, and peace to those who were near. For through him we both have access to the Father by one Spirit. Consequently, you are no longer foreigners and strangers, but fellow citizens with God's people, and also members of his household, built on the foundation of the apostles and prophets, with Christ Jesus himself as the chief cornerstone. In him, the whole building is joined together and rises to become a holy temple in the Lord. And in him, you two are being built together to become a dwelling in which God lives by his Spirit. Thus ends the second lesson for today.
Second Sunday Promium. Let us pray to the Lord for his grace and mercy.
Merciful Lord, have mercy and help us.
Make us worthy, O Lord, to offer to you continually praise and thanksgiving, glory, adoration, and unfading majesty. O good Master, who of his indescribable mercy did come among us of his own will without our seeking, that we may be saved from death, who by his bodily sufferings has wiped off our debts, and by his resurrection has brought immortality to our mortal race and granted joy and happiness to those above and to us below. To you belong praise, honor, and majesty at this time of prayer and all the days of our lives, forever and ever.
Amen.
O God, creator and maker of all things, who has power and glory in yourself, By your love and your own will, you came down for our salvation to suffer and to be crucified. You accepted insult, ridicule, and mockery from the Jews. You, judge of judges, was tried before the governor Pilate. You, who are exalted in the highest, above the cherubim, and are acclaimed with godly fear, you offered yourself to be nailed on a lowly cross. The sun was darkened when you were crucified, naked on the cross. The veil of the temple was torn by your grievous cry. The earth was shaken, and the rocks were sundered. You overcame death and Satan by your entrance into the grave. You restored life and hope to the dead. Your resurrection brought life to all creatures. Blessed Savior, in this the day of your redeeming and life-giving resurrection, we pray unto you for your grace. Make us immortal and imperishable, and liberate us from low and mean thoughts. Enable us by your power to be your faithful witnesses. Make us worthy to meet you joyfully at your second coming. To you and to your Father and to the Holy Spirit, we offer praise and glory forever and ever.
Amen.
You, God, are my God. Earnestly I seek you.
I thirst for you. My whole being longs for you, in a dry and parched land where there is no water.
I have seen you in the sanctuary and beheld your power and your glory.
Because your love is better than life, my lips will glorify you.
I will praise you as long as I live, and in your name I will lift up my hands.
I will be fully satisfied as with the richest of food. With singing lips my mouth will praise you. On my bed I remember you. I think of you through the watches of the night.
Because you are my help, I sing in the shadow of your wings.
I cling to you. Your right hand upholds me. Praise be to you, O Lord, forever.
Glory be to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, as is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
O God of our fathers, establish our foundation on the rock of the faith of the prophets and apostles. Build us upon the proved cornerstone, even Christ, who is the cornerstone of the Holy Church.
O Lord, bless us.
O God, shed your mercies upon our bishops, priests, deacons, and the people who are entrusted to their care. Sprinkle your dew of life upon them, so that they may maintain the true doctrine for the glory of our Lord and Savior Christ.
O Lord, bless us and help us.
O Lord, we pray thee for all those who are in authority, statesmen, legislators, and all, especially the King, Prime Minister, Cabinet Ministers, and all others who hold offices in the country. Grant them wisdom, the spirit of cooperation, and trust in God, and lead them under your guidance to do good.
O Lord, hear our prayers. Amen.
Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we thank you for bringing us together on this beautiful and glorious Sunday morning to praise and glorify your holy name. We thank you for your presence with us, Lord, as we participate in this online divine service from our homes and wherever else you have placed your children. Heavenly Father, we remember at this time your children who are celebrating their birthdays and wedding anniversaries in this month of February. Thank you for your abundant blessings upon them in the past year. It is only by your grace they are able to celebrate another birthday and wedding anniversary. May each one of them draw closer to you and deepen their love for you and each other. Grant them the strength to face and endure every struggle and challenge in life with faith and trust in you. Heavenly Father, we pray also for all members of our Klang Thoma Church. We surrender each one of them, young and old alike, into your hands to continue to bless, guide and protect them through every point in their life. We remember especially the elderly members of our community, some of whom are living alone and facing various struggles related to health, finance, lack of companionship, church fellowship, etc. Father, we pray that they will experience your peace and comfort in a greater way and put their hope and trust in you always. At this time, we bring to you A.T. Thomas' uncle, who underwent a successful surgery to his hip on Friday. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you. He is now recovering well by your grace. Father, we pray that uncle will experience speedy healing and recovery to enable him to get back on his feet again. We also pray for uncle's family to cope well in this situation and be a source of strength and blessing to uncle. Father, we remember all our churches throughout the globe, especially our main church in Kerala, and the leadership of the church. May the love of Christ be reflected in the ministry of the church, especially during this time where the world is going through a tremendous time of change. Not a single nation can claim exemption, as this COVID-19 virus is everywhere. We know that you are healing this world as you have heard the cries of your children. We thank you, Lord. Please forgive us our sins and iniquities that has brought this plague upon this world. Thank you for humbling us and reminding us that you, Father God, is the one who is in control of everything. We are nothing without you. Thank you for reminding us never to take your blessings for granted. Thank you, Lord, once again for bringing us together in this manner. We thank you for all who are able to follow this service this morning, Father God. Bless each one of them. Bless everyone with a wonderful day and a wonderful week ahead. Thank you, Heavenly Father, as we pray and ask all this in the mighty and matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. First of all, let me express my gratitude to my brother Shahji, the office bearers, and Achan for this opportunity to bring this word of God through this online platform. Today, the Thoma lectionary marks the beginning of the Great Lent. And the topic for today is transformation of creation. And the epistle reading for this week is from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, from 16 to verse 21. But I will be only taking two verses, which is the 17, verse 17 and verse 20. So verse 17 goes like this. Therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creation. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things become new. Verse 20, therefore we are ambassadors of Christ, since God is making his appeal through us. Let us pray. Almighty God, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful time that you've given us, this opportunity that you have brought for us. O Lord, as we speak here, let it not be our words, let it be your words, Almighty God. Let all wisdom come from you. Let all glory be to your name, O Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. We ask all this in Jesus' name. Amen. On the 9th of this month, that was a few days ago, UAE Hope Probe satellite, which they launched about 7 months ago, entered orbit at 7:42 p.m. This is a great achievement. The first Arab country to have sent a satellite this far, and also the fifth country in the world to have achieved this. The most beautiful thing which I noticed about this was the director of the project, as soon as they received the news that the probe has entered orbit successfully, it only had a 50% chance, but then they achieved it. The first words that he used was, "All thanks to Allah." He repeated this 3 times. Let us ask ourselves, have we given all glory to God for all our successes? Have we said thank you to Him? Are we living in a way that He has called us to? That is what we need to ponder today. When we talk about the transformation of creation, we see the epistle reading, we are a new creation and we are its ambassadors. And therefore we need to look and we need to understand what we need to do. When we turn to Matthew chapter 5, verse 13 and 14, it says like this, you are the salt of the earth. And verse 14 says, you are the light of the world. Believers, therefore, are the salt and light. And we need to know what is this salt and light and how, as salt and light, what we need to do in our lives. Therefore, the transformation happens, especially during this Lent period, the 50 days Lent, how we need to meditate, how we need to pray, what we need to do, and how the Lord has called us to be what it is, what we are. Salt. If you look at salt, there is 40 million tons of salt required every year for the human need. That's a lot of salt. Ancient Greece, they used to give a salt ration to the Roman soldiers. And the name was given as Solarium Argentum. And this is the name, the forerunner name for the English word celery today. And I believe all of you know about Napoleon Bonaparte, who went to war. And upon reaching Moscow, he was here to retreat. And while he retreated, or most of his troops died because their wounds would not heal, because their bodies lacked salt. And those days wars were fought over salt. Economies were based on salt. Do you know that the human body contains 4 ounces salt? Without enough of it, muscles won't contract, blood won't circulate, food will not digest, the heart will not beat a beat. Without a doubt, salt is one of the most important essence of life. Here it is interesting to see, Jesus said, you are. He did not say you should be, or you might be, or you will be. What he said is, to those who belong to him, you are salt. Now, question is, how good a salt are we? Let's look at the first two characteristics of salt. Salt acts as a preservative. Those days there were no refrigerators. In the olden days, people used to rub salt on their meat and kept away to delay the decomposition and also decay and spoiling of the food. And also salt is also a seasoning. It adds flavor to food. So if salt is a preservative, what Jesus is saying here is we are also to be a preservative, meaning stopping corruption, preventing moral decay and decomposition. Being a preserving agent often means being an irritant, calling the world to God's standard. We cannot be sitting in the comfort of our homes and communities and declare that we are being a preservative. And to be a flavor, we are to be a flavor. Jesus commanded us to love our enemy, to forgive those who have wronged us, to act with the purest motives. There is no such thing as unsalty salt. Jesus said, if salt has lost its saltiness, it will be thrown out. The fact is, chemically speaking, salt cannot lose its saltiness. But salt can become polluted, can become defiled. Salt in Jesus' days had impurities because it was obtained by evaporating water from the Dead Sea, leaving behind salt and other impurities such as the crystallized gypsum, which looked very much like salt and can be mistaken for salt, except that it does not taste like salt. With too many of these impurities, salt can lose its saltiness. What does it mean when we say salt losing its saltiness? George Murnau's research of religious belief and behavior of Americans has shown that the average Christian in the average evangelical church is almost indistinguishable from the rest of the society. Meaning, there is no difference. This is what he wrote: when Christian teens get pregnant and do drugs at the same rate as the general teenage population, when our marriages end in divorce at the same rate as the rest of the society, when we cheat, we lie, we steal, we commit adultery at the same statistical level as those who say they are not Christians, something is definitely wrong. What is polluting the church? Life during the week bears little resemblance to life on Sunday. On Sunday, everybody in church is very pious, very holy. But what happens the 6 days, the rest of the days of the weeks? If you see them somewhere, you will definitely not recognize them. It's not the same person you saw on Sunday. See, Paul warns Timothy about preaching what the world wants. In Ephesus, he asked him to order them to stop, because this is what is happening in the world today. Everybody preaches what everybody wants to hear, because they need their churches to be full. They need their churches to be receiving offerings. If you say what is the truth, nobody wants this. They want something to be soothing to their ears. And 2 Timothy chapter 4 verse 2 to verse 5 says this way: preach the word, be ready in season and out of season. Rebuke, correct, and encourage with great patience and teaching. For the time will come when people will not tolerate sound doctrine, but according to their own desires, will multiply teachers for themselves, because they have an itch to hear what they want to hear. They will turn away from hearing the truth and will turn away aside to myths. But you be watchful in all things, endure afflictions, do the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. But salt in a wound will burn, and so does the word of God. And we have a world around us that desperately need to be salted. We cannot have this words of roses. At some times it will prick. We need to tell the truth. It will burn. When you put salt in the wound, it will burn. But it is not to harm, not to hurt, for healing. So is the word of God. When the word of God is spoken and it hurts, this is for healing to take place. There was once a lady who was looking for a job. After some time, she got a job. And as she started to go to work, she went on the first day, she went on the second day. On the third day, she called her Achan, her father from the church. Say, "Father, father, I think I'm going to resign." So he asked, "What's the problem?" "Oh, they are not people like us. They are people who drink, and they are people who smoke, and they are people who have easy life. They are not God-fearing people." So the Achan asked her, "If you have a candle, where will you put it? So then the lady was not listening to what the Achan was asking. She is more engrossed into her own feeling. And she said, Pastor, Father Achan, you know, these people, they cheat and they lie and there is not a place for Christians to be employed. Then again, the Achan asked her, Sister or daughter, if you have a candle, where will you put it? And this time now she got very mood spoiled. She got very angry. She said, you are not listening to what I'm saying. I said, this is not a place to put. Pastor, these are ungodly people. They do profane jokes and they take the Lord's name in vain. Then the pastor stopped her. And Achan said, look here, listen, answer my question. If I give you a candle, where will you put it? For a while she stopped and she thought of it and it struck her. Naturally, you will put it in a dark place. A lit candle is to give light. She realized that God had a purpose for her in her life. That those people there, will some difference will happen. And sure enough, 6 months later, quite a number of them changed their ways, came to the Lord, and a lot of people were saved there. And she was instrumental to this because she was willing to. So just like Matthew chapter 5 verse 14 says, you are the light of the world. A city that is set on a hill cannot be hidden. It's already been prophesied in Isaiah 42 verse 6. I, the Lord, have called you in righteousness and will hold your hand. I will keep you and you give you as a covenant to the people, as a light to the nations. It's already foretold by God through Isaiah, that it your people give you as a covenant to the people, as a light to the nation, the people who are in Jesus. That light should not stay inside this church building, but taken out into the world around us. We are not to hang around safe places for Christians, but take our witness to the world. We are to dispel the darkness of the world and not cover up the light that we are called to be. Letting our light shine is dependent on being plugged into the source of light. John chapter 8 verse 12 says, Jesus spoke to them again, I am the light of the world. Anyone who follows me will never walk in the darkness, but will have the light of life. Therefore, we need to be plugged with Jesus. This is what Jesus is, the light of the world. We need to be plugged with Him. And once we are lighted, it cannot be hidden. It is just like the city on the hill. Today, this year, during this time of Lent, let us meditate on this. Let us meditate as a salt. How salt come into the world. All the decay, corruption, the things that is happening today. Let us be the preservative. As what is happening today, there's a big hoo-ha about the book written by Tansri Thomas. The truth always hurts. Yes, this is what Christians are called to be, to voice out the truth. May God bless him and be with him. And let us also remember that we are lighted. We are not to be kept under a closed basket, but we are to be placed on a high place where the light will shine forth to others. Let us, during this Lent period, let us ask ourselves, are we the salt of the earth? Now we are the light of the world. May God bless each one of us. May you have a wonderful time. God bless you.
Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
We believe in the one true God, the Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of the Father before all world, light of light, very God of very God, begotten not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary and was made man. He was crucified also for us in the days of Pontius Pilate, suffered and died and was buried. The third day he rose again, ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of the Father. He will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, and of his kingdom there will be no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father, who with the Father and the Son together is worshipped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets and apostles. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the remission of our sins and look forward to the resurrection of the dead and a new life of the world to come. Amen.
Othama, O Lord our God, glory to you forever, glory to you, glory to you. The Lord Christ, by your compassion and infinite grace, hear our prayers and accept our services. O Lord God, come for our help and cleanse us. O Lord, may our services be agreeable to you, our worship pleasing, our petition acceptable, and our prayers worthy of our acceptance. O Lord God, may your blessings, mercies, help, and all your divine gifts come upon us who are weak, and upon our weak human race, dwell among us forever. Benediction. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep our hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of the triune God, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, be with you, among you, protect you from all harm, and make you worthy of his gifts. Amen. May the peace of the Lord be upon you.
In his time.
Good morning. May the peace of Christ be upon you. Here are the announcements for today. We are moving on to the third service in this new norm, but the first with the announcements added in. On behalf of the parish, I wish to express our wholehearted appreciation to all members who led and assisted in organizing our online services. Our thanks to Mr. Varghese Matthew Kishore for the message this morning. Our prayers are with you and your family for your well-being and happiness. We also wish to thank Reverend Dr. Thomas Phillips and Reverend Matthew K. Punos, who will be leading in the services during the first and third Sunday of each month. As informed, we'll be closing our financial statement for the year 2020 on 28 February 2021. We are reminded of our financial obligations towards the needs of the parish. Please contact our trustees, Mr. Thomas Matthew Saji or Mr. Abraham Thomas Renji, for inquiries on your contribution, and note that all funds received after 28 February 2021 will be taken as contribution for the year 2021. Next Sunday, 21 February, our divine service will be led by Reverend Matthew K. Punos, and the service will begin at 9:30 in the morning. We will forward further announcements on the service by Saturday. Please do participate in the activities of the new norm till we are able to congregate as worshippers in our church again. Till then, stay safe. Hashtag Kita Jaga Kita, Kita Teguh, Kita Menang. Thank you.